I don't know about you, but sometimes I feel like everything in the world is changing faster than ever before thanks to technology. Students are learning with tablets instead of books. I'm seeing it with my girls. Roadmaps have become obsolete, and medical breakthroughs are saving more lives than ever before. A great example of this is genetic testing, now available to families everywhere. So here to explain are Dr. Christina Mailloux and registered nurse Dorothy Fitzsimmons. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for being here.
Good morning. Thank you.
You know, I love talking about these things because it's true. Our world has just changed dramatically over the last 30 years. Would you agree?
Absolutely.
And doctor, let me start with you. You're a geneticist, and help our audience understand exactly what that means and how it impacts healthcare today.
Genetics is a really revolutionary field in medicine today. It's really exciting, and what it basically is the study of DNA, which is the hereditary material you get from your mom and your dad, which is the building blocks of life. And we all have the same basic DNA, but we all have unique variants in our DNA. These are little changes that everybody has. And when we know information about these changes or these variants, we can actually make medical decisions based on that. And that's exactly what we do at Iverson Genetics. We do what is called pharmacogenetic testing. Mm-hmm. And what that is it allows your doctor to look at these changes in your DNA, these variants, and actually make decisions about which medications are best for you, what medication you would do well on or you might do poorly on, or even what dose of a medication might be right for you. So my role in the company is I'm actually a medical science liaison.
Okay.
I have my PhD in genetics, so that means I'm a scientist, and I educate physicians about how to utilize this testing in their practice and how to interpret the results so that they can provide more personalized medicine for their patients.
Excellent, excellent. Dorothy, let me bring you in. I was reading this morning and I jotted this down. 80% of all healthcare decisions are made by women. That's a lot, 80%. Tell me, you know, because you're a nurse, tell me how you fit in all of these decisions, if you will.
As a critical care nurse and vice president for clinical affairs for Iverson Genetics, at bedside, nurses are very well aware that what may work very well for one patient may not work at all for another patient. Mm-hmm. By doing our DMEX genetic tests, we're able to identify these variants. This assists the clinician in getting the patient on the right drug, right dose, right now. Families now are able to personalize and participate in their health care with their clinician.
Which is really important because I hear that word participation, and more people are really getting educated today, especially with the internet and everything that they have available to them. But here's my question to you, doctor. Are doctors today offering that information? Because I grew up with my dad and he's a surgeon and my grandfather also was a doctor and I never heard conversations like this. I'm a pre-med student, never heard about this. So are they really offering it up or do we have to say, hey, have you heard about this?
There's a little bit of both going on.
Okay.
As I mentioned, since genetics is such a new field, we have to do a lot of education. And Iverson Genetics is really leading the way in educating the physicians. But you as a patient also can go in and ask your physician for these tests, and that helps in our education efforts.
This is great information. Ladies, I want you to stay right there because when we come back, we're going to find out how genetic testing is helping to determine breast cancer risk, a topic on many women's mind today. So stay right there. Welcome back, everyone. Now, wouldn't it be wonderful if you could have a much better idea if a prescribed medicine was going to work for you before you started taking it? Even better than that, wouldn't you want to know if it could do more harm than good? Well, now you can with the help of genetic testing. Back with us again are Dr. Christina Mailloux and registered nurse Dorothy Fitzsimmons. Thank you so much for staying with me, ladies. Doctor, let me start with you. Give me an example of how genetic testing can help with treatment options, especially when we talk about breast cancer.
Right, so Iverson Genetics is really focused on women's health. We just came out with a new panel to assess a woman's risk for developing breast cancer. But we also have a test that can look at treatment options, in this case for breast cancer. We know that tamoxifen has been the gold standard in treating breast cancer.
Correct.
But there are some women that don't respond well to this drug. And the reason being is that it's a prodrug. And what that means is it has to be activated in the body to exert its effects. And some women have DNA variants that don't allow them to activate this drug in the body.
So if they take it, it's almost as if they were taking nothing?
Correct.
Really?
But with the help of genetic testing, a doctor can know this before he puts the patient on a treatment option and can choose an alternative treatment option instead for this woman.
Which is really important because it goes back to something you said earlier, and I think I'm quoting you correctly, Dorothy. You said right drug, right dose, right now.
Absolutely. And pharmacogenetic testing is crossing all areas of medicine. Testing is being done in the pediatric population, cardiac population, psychiatry, cancer. So these are all areas that testing is being utilized to personalize it and identify the DNA variants.
And Dorothy, talk to me a little bit more about Iverson's new Women's Health Panel.
The EMATAB test developed by Vanderbilt University, who has now partnered with Iverson Genetics, identifies not only the genetic factors, but also the environmental factors. And this is a first of its kind test. How is it helpful for women? Women present in three different categories. A woman sitting on the fence, should I take hormone replacement or shouldn't I take hormone replacement? If the test comes back that she's at a high risk, she may decide to manage herself in a different way by not taking hormone replacement. Mm. Then there's that low-risk woman who takes the test, but she's having many issues, so she's more comfortable getting on the hormone replacement. And then there's that high-risk patient who needs the medication, but she's a high risk. Identifying this upfront helps her and her clinician decide what is the best way of treatment on getting on hormone replacement and maybe length of time on hormone replacement that she may utilize.
And I can see how all of this could just help not only with saving lives, but saving time and saving money at the end of the day as well. Doctor, let's bring it home if you can with me right now. Tell me what you think the future holds with personalized medicine.
I think medicine is going to move from a more reactive approach to a more proactive approach to medicine. We know that there are DNA variants right now that we can take actionable steps, so we can use them to make medical decisions. And I think in the next 5 to 10 years, we're going to get our entire genome sequenced so that we can know all of our DNA variants, so that hopefully in the future we can actually take actionable steps for all of those variants. But right now, Iverson Genetics is offering panels that allow doctors to do this right now. So we can move from a trial and error form of dosing to a more genetic prescribed form of dosing.
It's very exciting. Dorothy, any final thoughts?
Yes, adverse drug reaction is a major problem here in the United States. There's over 100,000 deaths a year, which is twice as many as car accidents. So by utilizing genetic testing and identifying the variants, we're able and hopefully will lower that number.
Well, let me tell you, when there's more information and more great news coming out, I'd like you ladies to join me again and give me an update.
Thank you
very much. And if you'd like additional information about genetic testing, log on to the website, thebalancingact.com. That's thebalancingact.com. We're also on Facebook and Twitter.